School lunches. Some 28 to 75 million are served up across the country each weekday. But growing questions are concerned, not just about food safety, which we'll be talking about shortly, but the Trump's plan to allow more sodium and one percent milk. So thanks to abcnews.gov.com, we're looking at what we're going to do is I'm going to read you the sample of the article once this loads up. So what that circle is saying is U.S. Department of Agriculture is easing school lunch regulations superheaded by the Obama administration. That was back then when Michelle Obama wanted to make everyone healthy and not be obese. The new rules take into the 2017 and 18 year. So back in 2010, Michelle Obama introduced the Let's Move initiative. But what she wants to do is like add less sodium. Like what he wants to do is add like less sodium to each and every one of the foods. Like, back then, there was the Healthy Hunger Free Kids Act by Michelle Obama. But the calories, let's talk about the calories. Calories high schoolers get to 850. The guidelines back then were to throw away the puffy white bowl and the potatoes. Now there's fruits and vegetables, all the stuff that your mother wants you to eat. Our mother right now is Uncle Sam. If you watch 2020 segment on Classroom Confidential, then you'll know what I'm talking about. But here's something from the New York Times. Trump takes aim at school lunch guidelines and girls' education. What does girls' education have to do with school lunches? The problem is, school lunches are like a big deal for her. He's trying to add some sodium, more sodium to this, and add 1% milk. Not 2%, 1%. Back then the food was disgusting. Like if you packed it nicely in a box and ship it all the way to Africa, not only would they smell the vomit, but they would eat it, vomit it back into the box with the last grains of rice, and ship it right back here. Cardboard and plastic it was back then. Here's a sample from New York Times. Beginning the next school year, schools can request an exemption from the whole grain requirements to daily sodium. They will also be able to serve 1% flavored milk instead of non-fat. That's good. Because we're trying to eat more healthy. Back then we had sodium issues, but they banned those because of obesity. That is the number one thing. Oh! How nutritious was it for food safety? And the truth is much now that Trump's involved. Well, Trump is the president, but he's adding in more 1% of milk to increase the volume intake of food of the school of the Healthy Hunger Free Kids Act 2010. But why don't he want to add 1% of milk? Whole grain requirements and delay the sodium mandate. Why would he you do that? Listen to what Kent Cook said. Just because children would rather eat healthy, salted, processed foods at school doesn't mean they should. Really? The president's fondness for Big Macs and KFC is well known, but we shouldn't let Colonel Sanders and McDonald's run the school cafeteria. But if they were, and here's the thing, if they were to, you know what would happen if they were to? What would happen is that, they would have to close their business, take all of their shit, and move into the school cafeteria. That's like camping out in the Texas State Aquarium or the USS Lexington. Take all your shit and put it right by your beds. Same thing. Take all your shit and put it in the Texas State Aquarium. Vomit at the last grains of woods. If that were to happen, they just package that shit right back to America. How nutritious was that? So nutritious that food safety was involved. I'll get to that in a second. What I want to get to right now is the latest in Trump's school lunches. The very latest is going to be on July, in 2 months from now. But what are you going to expect that for next year? What if the schools complain? CCISD wants to do this next year, but I don't know if we're going to be able to do it next year. So I don't know what they're doing. They're probably getting rid of Mrs. Obama's. But what about why would he want to remove this 2010 law? They're trying to make what that program did was just trying to make kids healthy. Now that Obama's out of the way, we have Trump. What he's doing is just trying to add 1% of milk and less and take away the sodium intake. So here's the thing, this is what Mr. Purdue said. If kids are eating the food and it's ending up in the trash, they're getting nutrition, thus undermining the intent of the program. That's why Trump wanted to get rid of the program, because he wanted to add whole grains. Like that, well, the whole grains. Take away the salt increase. Delay the salt mandate and add 1% of flavored milk instead of not fat. Now moving on to food safety in school lunches. I'm going to go in detail what made me say give me a break. Going questions are raised about food safety in school lunches. Since 1990, more than 5,000 students and workers have gotten sick from being what's been served in their lunchrooms. There have been lots of critical violations in the schools of New York, Texas, Washington, Tennessee. Everywhere you go, mice shit. There was mice shit under the food, right under where food was served. There's mold, there's shit, there's piss, there's piss and shit under where food is being served. That can cause a health hazard. And what about this? Hamburgers not being kept hot enough. When food's not warm enough, there's bacteria, microbes, etc. But if this were to be a problem in South Texas, I wouldn't eat it. I would just toss this shit to the dogs. Let them eat it. You little fuckers, take that. Back then, going back to Trump school lunches, they didn't get enough nutrition. So Kansas wanted to do a music video, to parody the song "We Are Young," and we wrote the lyrics into "We Are Hungry." You know who wrote the lyrics? A teacher. Linda O'Brien. She took the hit song and rewrote it into "We Are Hungry." The principal gave them permission to do the video. 700,000 people watched the video and it got anonymous views. But here's the thing. Do they ever leave lunch hungry? I don't leave lunch hungry. And what about those kids who just take their food and stuff it in a fucking locker? Really? That's like a refrigerator. Let me tell you something. A locker is something to keep your stuff in for school. Not a refrigerator to put your fucking Fruit Loops and your pizza in. This is not going right to tell us when we don't have a refrigerator and stuff. You know, nuts or something. So go back to food safety. There's mice droppings everywhere. There's tons of stuff. Employees aren't washing their hands, hair, food. I'm going to discuss that in my food safety interview. What I call fast food safety coming up. Which will be coming up in like a few, coming up next week. But in the meantime, we'll get to the next to something else, maybe say, give me a break. Why? The question that made me give me a question, the thing that made me give a break is, drivers who don't know how to use a blinker. You know what a blinker is? Well, next. Do you use your blinker when you're driving? Do you see someone who's driving that don't know how to use a fucking blinker? Stick around, because I'm going to tell you more. Stick around, and we'll be back with more after this. This next topic is going up to all of you drivers who just get the message, who don't see what people do when they're driving. Many deaths have been caused by one thing they don't use. And what is it I'm talking about? They don't know how to use a fucking blinker! Do you know how to use a fucking blinker? You know what blinker is? It's a thing that looks like a pencil or a marker. I'm going to give y'all 7 reasons why this may be saying give me a break. From the HuffingtonPost.ca, 7 reasons why drivers don't use turn signals. There are plenty of terrible driving habits. Number 7 is, their turn signal is broken. That's probably a good thing, because if you don't know how to use turn signal, you're dead. You're probably... It may be broken. Maybe you have to get a replacement before you ever use it. Number 6, if it gets you... get to turn off their signal. When you're like, and you're still turning, and you're like, oh, the blinker's still on, I gotta turn it off. No, they just don't know how to fucking turn off a blinker. They just go like, get over that, Larry. So number 7, their turn signal is broken. Number 6, if you get to turn off the signal. Number 5, they're too fucking lazy. They're too lazy to just turn on the blinker when they're turning. They don't know how to use a blinker. It's like if someone's trying to turn and you're trying to run in, trying to go through traffic, you're going as fast as you can. There are many deaths that have been happening where drivers don't get the message for how to use a blinker. Number 4, they want to cut you off. No move. They don't show a turn signal, they can just quickly slip in the lanes before they can block their access while bumping everyone in West, meaning they just want to let them die or something. Number 3, they think the turn signal is optional. No matter where you're driving, you always have to use a blinker. A blinker is something that's like a pencil or a pen. And number 1, they also make it turn on their signal. Like, if you're stopping at a red light, you want to turn left or right, you don't know if it gets to turn on your blinker. So picture a wheel. Picture this tab for health care purposes, how to use a blinker like this. Wanna go left? Go left. Wanna go right? Go right. It's not that hard. A blinker is right there with you. It's your best friend. Jeez. In a moment, I'll give y'all some. I'll give you my take on drivers who, in a moment, all kinds of drivers, you won't want to believe the words I say. Stay with us. Here's the thing, I don't see people wearing makeup while driving, but this is what happens. You want to put your makeup before you drive? Not a problem. Not a problem, no big deal. You're just guilty of not putting on your makeup is what you're doing. That's what you are. You're guilty of not putting on your makeup. Oh shit! I got turned! You're missing your turn signal. That's a health hazard. It's really a health hazard according to ESSILORUSA.com. That's dangerous. Now here's another one. Drivers who swerve on lanes. Picture this. For technical physical purposes, a lot of drivers swerve. Should I make this lane? Should I make that lane? No, let's go swerve. Yeah. Let's go swerving. Yes. Swerving. find the answer because I can't find anything. Just pick a lane! Just pick a lane already! Don't go swerving! Okay, let's do this other thing. Should I do this one? And this one? Or this one? This one? This one? And all you hate is drivers who wait about 30 minutes for their parking spots! Really? You can't wait to have your parking spot? You're like, bro, I'm a date back! I'm a date back! You wait like 30 seconds, like going, oh, the spot just opened, right? You sit there, you sit in the fucking parking lot when it's like, other spots open, three other spots open to where you, on the other hand, don't know there's 30 other spots when you want that spot when someone stole your spot. Another thing I hate, drivers who text while they're driving. Not similar to DWI, John Wontoski, or DWD, drinking while driving, but texting while driving. This is the biggest issue. It's like looking at the phone and going, this what did they just try to get on the phone? This is why the law was in place to stop drivers from texting while driving. Those people need to go to the fucking Marines to get taught how to be disciplined and stuff. But the thing is with drunk driving, they don't know the law. These are like people who just go like,
I had a good time.
You don't realize you're asleep. You know, drinking and driving is not good. Neither is texting or driving. There are many deaths that happen because of drinking and driving and alcohol. I'll stand next week. And another thing about driving is they're being way too nice to you. Way too nice. Why? Because you stop right there, let's go, okay, hurry up, go, move. Thanks, butt face. Sorry. And what about drivers at? That's right, that driver's at. This is a good issue to bring up a point. Driver's issue is good. It's teaching you how to, when you're in a car, what should you do? Like, if you're in a red light, what would you do? Stop. You're in a red. You slow down. You're green. You go. You're in that part on the curb. You can't, this is not like a drift race where you just go speed. You just go speed whenever you want to. And speeding tickets. These are the kind of drivers who like to speed, go over the speed limit. Meaning, if when I was at school, when you're speeding on a school zone, the police will come and get you. They don't know that you're speeding. Another one, drivers who don't know the stop sign on a fucking bus. There's a stop sign on every bus. They don't see the stop sign and go, I'm sorry, I can't do that. I gotta get my kid to school. Bye. Really? There is a fucking stop sign on the fucking bus. Hey, your fucking problem is you fucking know how to stop. The brake is on your left foot. You don't know how to fucking use a brake, but you know how to use a fucking acceleration. What are you, a stupid driver? Give me a break. Drivers who just cause traffic. They said Gizvoodoo.com. Drivers are, these are the type of drivers who just sit, who just cause traffic. Like, you'll be driving slow. You'll be driving slow. Like, if you're smoking marijuana, you're driving slow. When it's illegal in Texas, you'll smuggle it to California, take it into Texas, smoke it, and then drive it. You may have seen an episode of Boondocks, with the Boondocks and Arnold Schwab, but buddy, this is real life. In Texas, it's illegal. California is legal to smoke weed with a prescription. If you need to text someone, go up to the car and text. You want to call somebody? Go to the car and call. That's all you got to do. It's that simple. Give me a break. When I'm talking about the drivers just stopping on the road, text their BFF or their mom or blah, blah, blah. If you're going to do that, go into the middle. Go into the fucking crib. If you guys put up, for you girls out there, if you're here to put up a make before while you're driving, too bad. Wake up a little bit earlier. Do it a few minutes earlier before you go in the car so that you don't have to stress out saying, oh, I didn't put my makeup because I forgot. You can't do that while you're driving. If it's rush hour, you're going to work. Jeez, we have too many trucks. Give me a break. School lunches and drivers and stupid drivers. Give me a break. I don't know what to say. Back in just a moment. The new item, everything, this goes up every day. Drunk driving and texting while driving. Those two topics will be on Monday on Give Me a Break. That's our show. Thanks for watching. If you haven't seen the playlist of the Give Me a Break series, you're welcome to check that out. Go check out my channel or I'll create a playlist and they'll give you Give Me a Break. You'll find each episode. You'll find each episode in the playlist. If you go to the description, below. You'll find each episode I talk about it, and you'll see my thoughts that have touched you in the bottom of the heart. For all of us on YouTube, all over the world, have a safe weekend. Don't text and drive. Don't drink and drive. Have a good time. Have a great weekend, and good night.